From JBS Studios in Greater New York, this is the JBS News Update with Teisha Bader.
I'm Teisha Bader with the JBS News Update for Tuesday, July the 7th, 2020. Three rockets were fired from Gaza at southern Israel on Sunday. Code red alert sirens sent residents running for bomb shelters. Fortunately, the projectiles landed in open areas and there was no damage or injury reported. In response to the attacks, the IDF conducted airstrikes on Hamas' underground terror infrastructure. Later in the day, the IDF said another rocket was launched at Israel, this one intercepted by the Iron Dome missile defense system. The foreign ministers of Egypt, Jordan, France, and Germany issued a joint statement today against Israel extending sovereignty to parts of the West Bank. After holding a video conference on the matter, Sameh Shoukry, Ayman al-Safadi, Jean-Yves Le Drian and Heiko Maas said any annexation would be a violation of international law and that they would not recognize any changes to the 1967 borders that are not agreed by both parties in the conflict. Adding, we also concur that such a step would have serious consequences for the security and stability of the region and would constitute a major obstacle to efforts aimed at achieving a comprehensive and just peace. It could also, they said, have consequences for the relationship with Israel. Well, Israelis appear to be split as to how they feel about Israel extending sovereignty, at least according to the Israeli Voice Index, a monthly survey conducted by the Israel Democracy Institute. For June of 2020, the survey found that 24.5% of Israelis support applying sovereignty to all of the West Bank or Judea and Samaria, 14% support applying sovereignty to the settlement blocks there only, 8% to the Jordan Valley only. 25% oppose applying sovereignty to any parts of the West Bank, and another 28.5% said they do not know. When asked if Israel should still apply sovereignty if it is conditioned on the establishment of a Palestinian state, nearly half, 49%, said it should. 38% said it should not. And just over half of the respondents said they feel there is a low or very low chance that Israel will go ahead with such plans this year. Pro-Israel lobby AIPAC, meanwhile, weighed in on efforts by Democratic Maryland Senator Chris Van Hollen's filed amendment against Israel should it take action extending sovereignty to parts of the West Bank. The amendment is proposed to be to the fiscal year 2021 U.S. National Defense Authorization Act to bar Israel from using U.S. security aid for any annexation actions. Van Hollen spearheaded the amendment with support from Senators Elizabeth Warren, Bernie Sanders, and Chris Murphy. He tweeted, "I will strongly support robust security assistance for our friend and ally Israel, but our assistance shouldn't be used to aid and abet Netanyahu's illegal scheme to unilaterally annex parts of the West Bank, killing a two-state solution and peace prospects." AIPAC tweeted in response that it opposes the Van Hollen amendment, saying it politicizes U.S. support for Israel's security and contradicts the Memorandum of Understanding of the Obama administration and goes far beyond current law in ways that damage American interests, risk Israel's security, and make peace less likely. Israel named its first Bedouin ambassador. Ishmael Kaldi will serve as Israel's ambassador to Eritrea, the first Bedouin Israeli to serve as an Israeli ambassador abroad. Kaldi is also the first Bedouin Israeli to serve as a diplomat in the foreign ministry, which he joined over 10 years ago, and has since held a number of posts, including as acting consul in Miami, Florida. Israel's Ministry of Defense and Israel Aerospace Industries announced the successful launch of the Ofek 16 reconnaissance satellite yesterday. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu told his cabinet meeting that the success of the Ofek satellite very much increases our ability to act against Israel's enemies near and far alike. Defense Minister Benny Gantz called the launch an extraordinary achievement. He said technological superiority and intelligence capabilities are essential to the security of the State of Israel. The fact, he said, that Israel is one of the 13 countries in the world with satellite launching capabilities is not a given. We will continue to strengthen and maintain Israel's capabilities on every front, in every place. Taking a look now at our programming for tonight on JBS for Tuesday, July the 7th at 7 o'clock, Cantor Laura Bresnik, Reverend Bidi Stork, and Dr. Hiba El-Khatib discuss how Judaism, Christianity, and Islam view the stranger. At 8, Meirav Michaeli and Dori Gold debate the pros and cons of Israel's extending sovereignty over parts of the West Bank with Avi Meyer from the American Jewish Committee's virtual global forum of this year. At 9, Mark Golub sits down with Yishai Fleischer on L'chaim. At 10, Martin Fletcher talks about his book, Promised Land, a novel of Israel. And coming up next, Shachar Azani speaks with Yusef Haddad, co-founder of the Arab-Israeli non-governmental organization Together Vouch for Each Other. He shares his passion for Israel and describes his fight against BDS and his struggle for further integration of Arab Israelis into Israeli society. And that's the JBS News Update for Tuesday, July the 7th, 2020. I'm Teisha Bader. Stay healthy, stay well.